Welcome to this screen demonstration on creating accessible PowerPoint presentations. We'll be applying the same rules we'd use to make any electronic document accessible. This video focuses on 7 key accessibility techniques specific to PowerPoint. By the end of this video, you'll understand the basics of how to create and distribute accessible electronic presentations that are compatible with assistive technology, such as screen readers and closed captioning. Interested in learning more? Check out the accessibility training video series on WakeTech's eLearning WTCC YouTube channel. The link is posted in the notes to this video. And there's a companion video on the channel called Creating Accessible Documents, MS Word 2010, that covers universal topics on document accessibility. There's a lot to cover, so let's get started. Begin by opening a blank presentation, and let's go ahead and save it using an accessible file name. Create names that are logical, meaningful to all users, simple to read, and relevant. A best practice is to use some kind of file naming convention. That looks good. Now, click Save in order to save this file in PowerPoint presentation format. We need to have our file in PPTX format in order to run the accessibility checker later on. We'll also want to identify the default language of the presentation so that a screen reader will provide the correct pronunciation. Up in the ribbon, click on Review Language Preferences. Here we see it's already set to English, so click OK to continue. Probably the most important step for creating presentations that are accessible for people who are using screen readers is to use the built-in slide layouts that are available in PowerPoint. These slide templates are efficient because they contain boxes called placeholders that hold the slide title, text, images, and are pre-formatted for different purposes. PowerPoint does not use a heading structure such as with Word, so it must be made accessible by using layouts and slide titles. From the Home tab, click on Layout and select a slide layout that will present your content in the best way. Give each slide a unique title, which will show up along with the content of the slide in the outline view. When you enter text into placeholders, there are font size and color attributes associated with them. Just type or paste your text and it will automatically format based on the template. Notice that the content placeholder defaults to bullet text, but allows you to format different kinds of objects, such as tables, charts, smart art graphics, images, clip art, and media. To create columns of text, look through the various layouts for a slide that's been pre-formatted with side-by-side placeholders. The screen reader will read column placeholders from top to bottom and then left to right, unless you change the reading order. Hyperlinks take the reader to another location when they click on active hypertext. In PowerPoint, a hyperlink could be used to connect one slide to another slide in the same presentation, or to a slide in another presentation, or could take the viewer externally to a web page or download a file. All hyperlinks should be uniquely identified and describe the destination, function, and purpose of the link. Ensure your link is active and that it goes to the intended location. You should always add an inactive, plain text link to the URL in the notes section of the slide. Let's review some techniques for making different objects accessible in a visual presentation. Any images, tables, charts, shapes, and other non-text graphics that you're using in your presentation need to have alternative text or alt text that conveys the same information as the image, so that those using a screen reader have access to what's represented in the visual. For a shape, picture, chart, table, smart art graphic, or other object, you'll want to right-click it and click Format Object, then click the Alt Text pane. In the description box, enter an explanation of the object. The description box should always be filled in. You may want to enter a brief summary in the title box. This box should only be filled in if you're entering a detailed or long explanation in the description. When you have complex content to describe, then filling in the title field is useful, so reading the full description is not necessary unless desired. Ensure that equivalent information to that contained in the description box is also available as text on the slide or in the notes section. Avoid placing text on top of images, as this can be difficult to distinguish and confusing to a screen reader. If you create your own image from two or more objects, group them together by holding the Shift key while selecting each one, then click Arrange and Group. Then right-click the new grouped image and under Format Object, enter a single meaningful description in the description box. Always check the reading order of your slide after adding shapes. You may need to do some rearranging. Reading order is covered toward the end of the video. Data tables are objects used on slides to display content in a grid, as in rows and columns. When using one of the built-in layout templates, click on the Insert Table option found in the content placeholder and indicate the number of rows and columns you'll need. Be sure to choose a table style with good contrast between the text, background of the cell, and grid line colors. Think about the meaning that you want to convey by presenting content in this way. Write a textual description that provides equivalent information to people with visual impairments. The description should include trends or other points of interest to aid understanding the content. The three formatting guidelines for creating accessible tables are to use a simple structure, specify a header row, and provide alternative text descriptions. Make sure the text color you use in your presentation provides enough contrast with the background color so that viewers can easily read it. As a rule of thumb, choose solid color text on a plain, solid, no pattern background. To compare different color combinations, use a web-based tool that checks the color contrast ratio of background and foreground colors, such as WebAIM. A quick way to check for contrast issues is to look at all of the slides using the grayscale option. To do this, select View and Grayscale. If you plan to use digital multimedia in your presentation, it must give equivalent access to the content for people who are blind or have low vision, and those who are deaf or hard of hearing. Transitions and animations are popular formatting features that add motion and blinking effects to objects and when moving between slides. Moving and blinking elements may cause seizures in some people, especially if the motion repeats faster than 3 times per second. Even for readers without a disability, movement distracts the viewer's attention and is better left for situations where you want viewers to remain engaged with your content, such as during a live presentation. Remove transition and animation effects before distributing the presentation as a resource. Finally, give thought to how your presentation will look when printed. Ensure that your handouts are accessible and usable by everyone, and a printed handout should provide access to equivalent information found in the electronic version. Screen readers will follow the reading order of the slide layout. To check the reading order of a particular slide, navigate to the slide and press the Tab key to bring the keyboard focus to the first element. A box appears around the first placeholder to indicate where the screen reader will begin reading. Press the Tab key again to move the keyboard focus to the next element, and this is where the screen reader will go next. Continuing to press Tab will cycle through the reading order back to the first placeholder. If you want to change the reading order of a slide, first decide the order you'd like the slide to be read. Select the first element and then right-click for the Options menu and bring to front. Select the second item, right-click Options menu, bring to front again. Repeat this in order going through each element on the slide, and verify by tabbing through the reading order. You can also view and edit the reading order by using the selection pane. You'll want to check the accessibility of your presentation prior to sharing and distributing the file electronically. The accessibility checker checks your file against a set of possible issues that people who have disabilities might experience when trying to access your presentation. To run the accessibility checker, click File, Info, Check for Issues, Check Accessibility. This feature searches for common accessibility errors and presents the results in the pane on the right. Follow the instructions to fix each one so that viewers will have the best possible experience reading your presentation. A green check means your presentation is accessible. Success! Using the features reviewed here will help you create presentations that can be easily navigated and understood by all users. Thanks for watching.